The Scorpion News is a public forum for student expression. Students make all content decisions, and opinions do not necessarily represent those of the HUSD.
I'm your new anchor, Claudia Moore, reporting live from the studio.
Psych, just kidding. What's up? It's Tina Casella back with another broadcast.
So you're really going to cut me off like that?
Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. I'm Tina Casella.
And I'm Claudia Moore.
And we're back with some more announcements.
Auditions for the spring musical Beauty and the Beast will be held Thursday, January 10th in the drama room and Friday, January 11th in the choir room. You will need to sing 30 seconds of a song of your choice, and you will be giving a short scene from the play to read. There will be plenty of time to rehearse before your audition. This audition is open to all students, so come out and be a part of this exciting experience. See Mr. Cottrell in room P24 for more information.
Are you interested in seeing how talented our Scorpions are? Check out the Winter Instrumental Concert tomorrow in the gym. The show begins at 6 o'clock p.m. and is free to all. Yep, you heard it, free.
$0.
So be sure to come out and watch them showcase all their hard work. They're definitely putting in hard work today, huh?
Speaking of hard work, Ryan and Damian caught up with the mock trial. The mock trial just wrapped up their season, and we caught up with Justin Popoff to hear how the year went.
A mock trial is a club in which other schools and teams will go up against each other to really show off what they know and present their fact patterns that they know about the case given, and just presenting what they know about law, really. Along with that, you know, there's other positions that you could play as you know, like when you initially get the court case, you're a teamer. That's how we formulated it. Our team picked specific roles for each person to play in that case. So.
Can you tell us like what kind of process you go leading up to a trial?
So the process that it takes, we have attorney coaches, and along with like our actual teacher coach, Mr. Maxwell, we had two attorney coaches. They would just help us on, and they couldn't obviously always make it because they were actual attorneys. So sometimes we had to help each other just out throughout the team, just try to sharpen up on our fact patterns and what we know about the case. Try to sharpen up on anything like objections or any bypasses to said objections about, and kind of like in our script almost, but it wasn't really a script because you can't, when you're going up against another team or another school, you can't really script that. You have to just go, pretty much. You have to think on your feet a lot of the times, which is something that's really big about it.
And what kind of people should join mock trial? Like, what skills do they need?
So for mock trial, it is obviously argumentative. That is, you have to know how to think on your feet really quickly, but that's not a necessity. You don't have to really learn, or I mean, you can learn how to think on your feet. So it isn't really, it really depends. It really does on just the person themselves. Because some people, they find the law interesting. And for those people that want to be lawyers or that want to be attorneys when they're older, then I think mock trial is a perfect experience for them, because when they go and apply for law school, these law schools will look at that and they'll see that you're in mock trial, and they'll be like, well, that's really cool. You were in mock trial. You had experience with this. You know what you're doing. You know objections and you know your fact patterns, and you're able to understand that. If you're interested in law and you want to be a lawyer, anything along those fields, like arguing, you're fast on your feet. Or you want to try something new, I say mock trial is a really good place to look for next year.
Good job, guys. continue the good work. For more information on signing up, see Mr. Maxwell.
Now, I'm sure you've noticed what month we're in. We're in the month of December, which means Christmas! And with Christmas coming so quickly, toy wrapping must be a hassle. So don't worry about that. CSF volunteers will be trained in gift wrapping, available to wrap your gifts.
Monday through Thursday for the next 2 weeks in the library from 2:30 to 4:30. Payment is by donation, but the recommended donation is only $1 to $2 for shirt-sized boxes. You can also set your appointment date and time by emailing your request to Ms. Gentilucci.
How are you at wrapping?
I've got a couple bars.
I'm not talking about that. Never mind. Scorpions, be sure to get your winter formal nominations in before the week ends. Nominations will be held today and tomorrow at lunch in the quad. Come to the table on the stage with your ID card ready to cast your nomination. Hey, seniors, be sure to nominate me, Tina Casella, and my best friend, Ashley Hobson, as your winter formal queens. And make my wish come true, because all I want for Christmas is your vote. What do you want for Christmas, Claudia?
All I want for Christmas is for you to watch this next segment. Cut the beat.
Everyone. Now back to the announcements. But first, get your holiday grams for $1 in the quad. Don't forget.
How do you feel about the district dress code policies? Do you think some of the policies are a bit outdated? If so, Mrs. Barnes and Mr. Bostock's innovation students created a little video for their change campaign. Let's take a look.
Oh my God, girl, I don't believe it. My boyfriend just left me.
Oh my God, those clavicles.
Those guys are so dumb. Did you just hear that? What
yeah.
They say about us?
A clavicle distracting your boys from education? I don't think so.
Have had 125 dress code violations. Changes already occurring within other districts, such as Alameda. They now allow the parents and the students to decide what's appropriate for school. No longer shall students be dress coded for clothing, such as short shirts, headwear, and torn jeans. We encourage you to help make a change. come by the stage at lunch on December 13th to sign our petition.
Great job, guys. Thank you for using your voices and standing up for what you believe in. If you'd like to support their cause, head down to the quad to sign their petition to get your voices heard.
In addition, other students from that class are getting involved with their own projects. Jalen Jenkins and Philippa Yuhas created the Embracing Love organizations. They both want to solve one problem in America through the LGBTQ community, which is hate speech, discrimination, and hate crimes. In order to learn more, please visit their website. Such a good website. I want to visit it right now.
The Otsuku Club are selling tickets for their Anime Pulse February 19th. The tickets are only $25 each. See Mr. Anderson in N26 for more for a purchase. Another way to get involved is by participating in your class events. Juniors, did you know that the junior class is in charge of Winter Formal and Powder Puff? Well, they are. And if you are a junior and would like to get involved in planning these events, be sure to come to the meeting every Monday at lunch in room E10.
Seniors, you can get involved by wearing your class of 2019 t-shirts. They are on sale now in the student store. Get yours for only $15.
Lastly, we all know final season is approaching.
And that means things are getting a little bit more serious. This means studying, turning in all your work on time, and taking some responsibilities, something that some students don't do.
We have a skit that puts some perspective on this issue. Enjoy!
Hey, did you turn in your final?
No, I failed.
Might want to go ask him about your grade.
I know, I think I'm going to go talk to him right now.
Hey, Mr. Bernard, are you busy right now?
No, how can I help you?
Well, you see, I didn't turn in the essay yesterday, and I was wondering if I can get an extension.
What kind of extension are we talking about?
I just need about 7 more days.
I don't think I can do 7 more days.
Please, Mr. B, you know I never...
Let you down. Well, you did. I was really let down by all the little work. You were able to do this semester.
Let me see.
There's no need to explain yourself. Every time I walk by your desk, I have to keep reminding you to look alive, look
alive. So you're gonna fail me? I would love a B minus. Why don't you just meet me
in the middle? Look, I'm sorry, but it's a little too late. Better luck next semester. Now excuse me while I attend to the rest of this line.
Thanks for that video, Nia and Ariel. Make sure all of you guys are ready for those finals over some weeks. Over some weeks, I collected some videos of best friends taking a test to see how well they know each other. Let's take a sneak peek and see what video is coming in 2019.
Vincent Mata, I'm a senior.
My name is Matthew
Atolano,
I'm a senior.
And how
did
you
guys
do? I had him in the class.
Yeah.
Where did that you ask that?
We met in Jeroma.
Actually, yeah. So we
play
Robin Hood.
Yeah,
we
met in Robin Hood.
So when I'm
playing.
Oh,
we gotta wait for
this.
You guys
are live.
We're live?
We gotta wait for this announcement.
Our parents were actually sisters. It's real. It's funny how you're laughing at our life, but where they can see us.
Kyler,
we
look okay.
Yeah,
fine.
I didn't even.
And what you teach? Right now?
Yeah. Our parents were actually sisters, and our dad actually brought us in to labor. So we went in, and while my mom was giving birth to me, I seen him.
No, it was you! Can't see
you
these things,
bright
lights, okay.
With his mom.
And
I was like, what's up?
At a football game.
Football game stretching. Pizza nuggets.
I honestly thought she hated me, but I did. We hated each other, but we're friends
but now.
But
I love her.
Great. I'm James Delaney, and I'm a senior. Dropout yet? Maybe? I don't know. But I'm a senior.
I'm Carlos Serrano, and I'm a senior.
Met in PE, remember?
Wait.
Here. Coaching chair and teaching anatomy together.
We met on my Minecraft server.
A wine server?
Minecraft.
No, Minecraft. Oh. No, we met in PE sophomore.
That's how we met.
Okay, enjoy.
Be sure to keep up with our YouTube and Instagram channels to see the rest of the video. We also have some highlights of the Great Hesperian Workout up there.